Hello, and a warm welcome to Heaven's Gate. I'm Emmanuel, and here we explore incredible real-life stories of those who have experienced glimpses of heaven and hell. If you're new to the channel, I completely understand if it feels overwhelming at first, but I encourage you to stay with us until the end. These stories are not only powerful and inspiring, but also hold important lessons rooted in the core of the Christian faith. Before we get started, I'd love for you to subscribe and enable notifications. This simple step helps us spread these remarkable testimonies and share God's word with even more people. Now, let's dive into the story. My name is Anna, and my life, until recently, was an ordinary routine, devoid of significant changes or extraordinary events. I was a woman like many others, absorbed by work commitments and family responsibilities. Every day seemed to flow the same as the previous one, and if someone had asked me what was missing in my life, I wouldn't have been able to answer. On the surface, I lacked nothing. I had a stable job, a circle of friends, a normal life. Yet, in moments of solitude, I felt a void inside me, something I didn't know how to fill. My childhood was marked by a constant presence, faith. I was raised in a devout Catholic family where my father was the beating heart of our spirituality. He was a man of deep faith and tireless prayer. I remember the evenings spent with him in silence, reciting the rosary or talking about God. At that time, those practices felt natural to me, part of my daily life. But as the years passed, my faith lost its vigor. Spirituality had become a routine, a series of mechanical actions without a true connection with God. The breaking point came when my father died. His loss devastated my soul and left me with a question. Where had he gone? He had always spoken with unwavering conviction about life after death, but I could no longer feel it as real. His words seemed distant, and I felt lost in a sea of spiritual confusion. Life continued after my father's death, but I was no longer the same. The routine became a refuge, a way to avoid thinking about the pain and emptiness I felt. Every week I went to church as I always had, but each prayer felt empty, meaningless. The words left my lips but didn't touch my heart. I was there out of duty, not desire. I often wondered if others in my life were living the same way, immersed in lukewarm faith, a Christianity made only of appearances. I had grown up with the idea that being a Christian meant going to church and behaving well, but I had never truly asked myself what it meant to have a personal relationship with God. As I continued attending religious services, my heart drifted further away. I prayed mechanically but didn't feel God's presence. My father's death had only strengthened my sense of loss. I visited his tomb every week, praying for him, but my words seemed to disappear into the wind. I wondered if God was truly listening to me, or if my prayers were in vain. The question that began to haunt me was the same one my father had asked me in the past. Where would you go if you died today? I couldn't answer. I had never taken the idea of hell or heaven seriously. I had been taught that God is love, that He always forgives, and I had lived my entire life believing that being a good person was enough to be accepted into heaven. But over time, that certainty wavered. I began reading the scriptures, seeking answers. The words of Revelation 3:16 haunted me. So because you are lukewarm, neither hot nor cold, I am about to spit you out of my mouth. I realized that my faith was exactly as described, lukewarm, lifeless. And if God had truly rejected my soul? My father had died with a solid faith, but I couldn't say the same about myself. I often wondered if he was at peace, if he had reached the paradise he had preached so much about. But me? Where would my soul go if death had caught me at that moment? Hell, a concept I had always considered distant, was beginning to seem more real. One rainy morning, I went to the cemetery to visit my father's tomb. I knelt down as I always did, but that morning something different happened. I felt a pressure on my chest, a weight I couldn't explain. It was as if all the pain, guilt, and confusion I had accumulated over the past few months were crushing me. The prayers I usually recited seemed to vanish into the air. I couldn't find the right words. I closed my eyes and did something I had never truly done before. I spoke to God with sincerity. It wasn't a formal prayer, but a cry from the depths of my soul. I asked God to show me the truth, to give me an answer. And it was at that moment that I felt a presence around me. I opened my eyes and saw something I could never have imagined. Before me stood a radiant being, enveloped in such pure light that I couldn't look directly at it. My heart stopped for a moment, and then an indescribable peace flooded me. It wasn't a human figure, yet it emanated a love and power I had never experienced before. The angel looked at me with eyes full of compassion and wisdom, as if it knew every thought I had ever had. I didn't speak because I knew there was no need for words. It already knew everything about me, my fears, my questions, and the void I felt. "Anna," it said in a voice that seemed both powerful and gentle, "the Father has heard your prayer. It is time for you to know the truth, to understand what you have always avoided." Its presence was so reassuring that my initial terror transformed into calm. I felt that God was speaking to me through it, and I knew this was the moment that would change my life. The angel explained that my life had been lived in a lukewarm manner, as if God were a secondary detail. I had accepted faith as a label, but had never truly opened my heart. "God loves you," the angel continued, "but he cannot be placed second. You have lived thinking that being a good person was enough, but true salvation requires much more. Your heart must be completely transformed. God is calling you to a new life, to a living faith." Those words deeply affected me. I realized how little I had understood about faith. I thought going to church and saying a few prayers was enough, but the angel was showing me that God desires much more. He desires my heart, my entire life. The angel explained that God is not only love, but also justice. Many, it said, hide behind the idea that God is love to justify their sins. But God is also holy and just. Sin cannot be ignored because it separates man from God. Those words made me tremble. I had always thought that God automatically forgave everything, but the angel showed me that sin cannot be tolerated without sincere repentance. God cannot coexist with sin, and those who continue to sin without repenting cannot be in communion with him. "Every soul," the angel continued, "faces two paths, salvation or perdition. Hell is real, Anna. It is not just a distant threat. It is the destiny of those who refuse to repent, who live far from God. But you can choose. You can still change." Those words struck me like lightning. I had never seriously considered hell, but now I felt it so close, so real. I realized that my soul was in danger. I felt deep shame for my lukewarm life, for taking God's grace for granted. But at the same time, I felt growing hope. There was still time to change, to repent, and to be reborn. In a sweet voice, yet full of authority, the angel explained the meaning of true repentance. God is merciful and ready to forgive, but repentance is not just a word. It is a radical change of heart. You cannot simply ask for forgiveness and continue to live as before. You must desire to be transformed, to be reborn. Those words resonated in my heart. I remembered Jesus' words in the Gospel of John. "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Until that moment, I had never truly understood what it meant to be born again. Now it was clear. I had to let God completely transform my heart. The angel's words were clear. But inside me, there was still a struggle. Part of me wanted to cling to the life I knew, to my habits and the comforts of the world. But another part, the part the angel had awakened, longed deeply for God, his peace, and his truth. I knelt before my father's tomb, with silent tears streaming down my face. I felt the weight of my past choices, my indifference toward God. But in that moment, I prayed sincerely for the first time in my life. Lord, forgive me. I have lived away from you for too long. Change my heart. Make me yours. I felt an incredible peace flood my heart. It was as if a huge weight had been lifted from my shoulders. The angel looked at me with a sweet smile, and in that moment, I understood that my life would never be the same again. I felt free, renewed. I had been born again. With a sweetness I had never experienced, the angel spoke once more. Your repentance is sincere, and God has forgiven you. The journey will not be easy, but now you have a new heart, and God will be with you. I felt a warmth inside me, as if God's grace had begun to burn away all the remnants of my past life. Finally, I was at peace, knowing that I had answered God's call. From that day on, my life changed completely. Faith was no longer an empty routine, but a source of daily joy and strength. Every morning, I woke up with the desire to pray, to know God more deeply. I no longer saw faith as a duty, but as a precious gift. I often returned to my father's tomb, but now with a heart full of gratitude. The overwhelming pain was gone, replaced by peace. I brought my children with me, and together we prayed for him, thanking him for the faith he had passed down to me. One day, shortly before the angel disappeared, I asked, "How is my father? Is he at peace?" The angel smiled and replied, "Now that you have found the way, your father is at peace too. He watches over you from above, proud of the path you have taken. He knows that one day you will be reunited, and until then, he watches over you with love." Those words brought me immense joy. I no longer feared death or judgment because I knew I was walking toward God. My father was waiting for me, and I knew that one day we would be reunited in peace and in the grace of God. Every time I looked at the tombstone, I no longer saw an end but the beginning of something greater, the eternal life that God had prepared for all of us. And my life, from that day forward, was dedicated to Him, with a heart full of gratitude and eternal love. I would like to send a message to all Christians who desire to live an authentic faith and find true salvation. My story is an invitation not to settle for lukewarm faith, lived only on the surface. Often we delude ourselves into thinking that attending church or following some religious traditions is enough, but it is not. God calls us to a true, deep relationship where every part of our lives is guided by His love and His will. God is love, but He is also justice. He is a holy God who cannot coexist with sin, and our spiritual lukewarmness is a form of distancing ourselves from Him. Without sincere repentance and a transformation of the heart, we risk being separated from God forever. Hell is not just a distant threat, but a reality for those who choose to live away from God. However, there is always hope. God is ready to forgive us, to give us new life through His mercy, but we must seek Him with all our hearts. As Jesus said to Nicodemus, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." This spiritual rebirth is what allows us to commune with God and live in His grace. We cannot limit ourselves to recognizing Jesus only as our Savior. We must also accept Him as our Lord, letting Him guide every aspect of our lives. Repentance is not just a fleeting emotion, but a conscious decision to change direction, to abandon sin, and to follow God's path. My invitation is not to wait, not to postpone. Today is the time to take your faith seriously, to choose God with all your heart. Every day is an opportunity to grow in His presence, to let yourself be transformed by His grace. Only then can we find true peace and the joy that comes from walking with Christ. I know that thanks to this transformation, one day I will be reunited with my Father in heaven, and this certainty is the source of my hope. If we open our hearts to God, we too can live with the assurance that one day, eternal life with Him awaits us. Thank you so much for staying with us until the end. If you enjoyed the video, I invite you to share it with 2 Christian friends. By doing so, you will receive a blessing and help spread God's word. If you haven't done so yet, I kindly ask you to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications to make sure you don't miss videos like this, which we post several times a week. See you soon in the next video.